A red tomato. Well balanced, well shaped. No taste. We are what we eat. Bad news.
As you know, there's already more than a billion hungry people on this planet. We're expecting that problem to get worse, and we can expect to have greater pressure on our food resources. And that's why the oceans need to be their most abundant, so that the oceans can provide us as much food as possible.
I was born to study one vegetable. Now granted, this one vegetable is the key thing for 800 million people's survival. You see, cassava is a poverty fighter. If a small-scale family farmer has healthy cassava, they can feed their family, and they have enough to generate income.
If the brain is not fed and stimulated in the first 1,000 days of life, we are depriving that child of a healthy development.
Anemia has serious consequences for human health and socioeconomic development. In science, we often learn that the simplest answer is the best. And so I charged myself and those around me with finding a solution to the problem, a simple solution, one that would be cost effective, one that would be environmentally sustainable, and one that would be accessible to even the most remote rural villagers.
So there's a constant push-pull there. There's a constant tough decision that has to be made between two very important things, maintaining biodiversity and feeding people. But in the oceans, biodiversity is not at war with abundance. In fact, they're aligned. We know that saving the oceans can feed the world, and we need to start now.
We have to empower the scientists and the people. It's going to take all of us, not just the agricultural sector.
And I say, planting is a political act. Planting a garden, planting an orchard, is for the future. It's for the next generation. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.